Hey everybody, Uncle Rich here for Who's Telling the Truth. Guys, this is show 167. Today's date is March 13th, and if you're wondering about the shamrocks, you're right, it's close to St. Patrick's Day and spring's coming. But we have a nor'easter in store for us tomorrow. That's right. We got more extreme weather coming. And of course, the people that don't understand global warming, the science of global warming, will never understand what extreme weather is. But, you know, in the New York area, in Danbury, Connecticut, we're supposed to get close to 2 feet, maybe more. And guys, we've been through this before. You know, I've been in the same house for over 30 years. This is gonna be probably our third or fourth big one. You know, but we almost got a big one 2 years ago, and the track missed us by about 50 miles. But today's show, believe it or not, is going to be called Sick and Tired. And, you know, initially, you know, I wanted to call the show Trumpanzees, you know, and we practiced this. Judy, what are you doing? Thank you. All right, can you bring it up full? All right. Guys, I don't mean to diminish Judy's skills, but I said to her, Judy, be ready with this, please. All right, but Judy, no, really, in the future. So anyway, you know, not to throw me off or nothing, but, so I was gonna name the show Trumpanzees, but guys, what happened in Southbury, there was a Trump rally. So we're gonna show you, and this is what happened on March 4th in Southbury. There was a rally for our new president, President Trump. And what I'd like to ask these people is, out of all those people that showed up, and they said there was about 200 to 300 people, out of the people that showed up, I wonder how many people voted for Donald Trump because he was gonna eliminate, he was gonna repeal Obamacare, and he was gonna replace it with something better and cheaper. Well, guys, now comes the time to put the cards on the table. And Donald Trump has found out that repealing Obamacare is not as easy as it seems. But guys, what's happened with Obamacare? And you have to remember, Obamacare is really called the Affordable Care Act. That's the name of the bill. That's how it was signed into law, the Affordable Care Act. But what does Fox and everybody on the right call the Affordable Care Act? Obamacare. And why do they call it Obamacare? Because if you hate Obama, it's easy to hate Obamacare. This is the way it works. This is the subtle brainwashing that takes place where Uncle Joey and the rest of the simple folk, and believe me when I tell you, they're simple folk because they vote against their own interest. And you're gonna say, Rich, what do you mean? What do you mean they vote against their own interest? Guys, they voted to get health care better and cheaper. When they find out that it's gonna cost so much more, are these people still gonna stand behind Trump? And this is what the first part of this show is going to be about. You know, and I asked Uncle Joey. I said, Uncle Joey, let me see if I can get this up on my computer. I said, Uncle Joey, you know, what do you think, you know, about, you know, Obamacare? And what do you think, you know, should be done? And Uncle Joey said, I see right through your selfish, libtarded ass. You're just worried about you. No, Joey, I'm worried about everybody because we're all in this together. health care affects the whole country. And when you understand this, when you get a handle on this, you'll be able to appreciate what Obama has tried to do for the country. But you know, guys, Uncle Joey told me, he said, as soon as I can get it, I'm going to sign up for Trump Care. So even though he's got to pay more money, and we're going to show you how people are going to have to pay more with Trump Care, as soon as he finds out he's going to have to pay more money, will he still do it? Yeah, Uncle Joey will still do it. And why? Because he's been brainwashed. He's so full of hate against Hillary and the Democratic Party and anything that isn't what Joey considers to be good is bad. Joey, Rich, you're not one of us. You're right, Joe. I'm not one of you, and I can't be one of you. I can't sell out. I can't sell out the idea of global warming isn't happening. I can't do it. I'm sorry. I don't have the loyalty that you have. And why? Why are you loyal to Trump? You know, Trump would have you eat a shit sandwich and you'd say, can I have another one, sir? Please? Because you've been brainwashed. And we're going to show you that the most average Americans don't understand the difference between Obamacare and the Affordable Care Act. But guys, we're going to have fun. Jimmy Kimmel did a clip, and he just stopped people on Hollywood Boulevard, and he asked him this simple question. So, Judy, let's have clip number one, please. That's the wrong clip, Judy. Number one, please. Number one, Obamacare versus the Affordable. There you go.
I've been hard at work looking to repeal and replace Obamacare right now. People have very strong opinions about the president's health care plan. And back in, I think in 2013, we conducted an experiment here on the show. We went on the street and we asked people which was better, Obamacare or the Affordable Care Act, which is anyone who knows anything about this subject at all knows Obamacare is just a nickname for the Affordable Care Act. They're the same thing. So with all the attention being paid to the subject lately, we decided to ask this question again to see if Americans have learned anything over the last 3 years. And, well, let's see if we have.
We're talking to people about health care today.
Okay.
Do you support Obamacare or the Affordable Care Act?
Affordable Care Act.
And why is that?
Well, I mean, I'm not the biggest fan of Obama, so I don't support him in the Obama things that he's got
There's
going
your
on.
Answer,
I'm
guys.
Actually really excited for President-elect Donald Trump, so.
Right. So you don't like anything Obama does, and you prefer the Affordable Care Act?
Absolutely.
Do you support Obamacare or the Affordable Care Act?
I support Obamacare.
So if you were a senator and you could vote today, you would vote to keep Obamacare instead of the Affordable Care Act?
Yes.
Do you support Obamacare or the Affordable Care Act?
I guess the Affordable Care Act.
And why do you prefer the Affordable Care Act over Obamacare?
I'm not really sure. My girlfriend supports Trump, so I go with whatever she says.
What is the main difference between Obamacare and the Affordable Care Act?
One is you pay, and then the other one is Obama pays for you.
Right, Obama pays, pretty big difference.
Pretty big difference.
What makes Obamacare better than the Affordable Care Act?
It's more affordable for the less fortunate, I'd say.
So Obamacare is more affordable than the Affordable Care Act?
I'd say it is.
I believe that Obamacare, the premiums are too much, too high, so people are end up paying more.
Right.
So I believe in the Affordable Care Act.
And so the Affordable Care Act is more affordable than Obamacare?
Right, correct.
Right, right.
Which is obvious based on the name.
It's in the name, right.
Right.
Why do you like the Affordable Care Act more than Obamacare?
Because I don't like Obama.
But you like the Affordable Care Act?
Yeah.
What if I told you Obamacare and the Affordable Care Act are the same thing? We're talking about health care with people out here today.
Tight.
Do you support Obamacare or the Affordable Care Act?
You know, I'm kind of like...
Can you repeat the question?
Sure, yeah. With healthcare, do you support Obamacare or the Affordable Care Act when it comes to healthcare?
I guess, I mean, Obama's pretty tight, so I guess I'll probably go with him.
Sure, sure.
Yeah.
How stoned are you right now?
Pretty stoned. Yeah.
Do you know what your current healthcare insurance plan is?
I don't know, man. I don't even think I have health insurance.
Not at all?
No, I think my mom took me off her health insurance. Shout out to my moms.
Thanks for watching. If you like that, subscribe to our YouTube channel for all...
Isn't that terrific? And guys, you know, getting back to Uncle Joey. And I love Uncle Joey, don't get me wrong. But, you know, I asked him, you know, I told him the name of the show was going to be Sick and Tired. And he said, what are you sick and tired about? People figuring out that you're a fake and a BSer? Or that you are a parrot and a puppet for your handlers? And I answered to Joey, I said, Joey, I'm sick and tired of seeing the Republican Party taking advantage of you simple folk who are too stupid to realize you're being screwed. And this is what it comes down to. And you know, people say, well, you know, Rich, you say Uncle Joey's brainwashed. Guys, the brainwashing is not done with a floodlight on you, under intense pressure with water. No, it's very subtle. And Fox News does it over and over and over. You know, the failed Obama policies that have been enacted, and you'll go, oh, failed Obama policies? Oh, okay. Yeah, I guess they're all failed. And this is how it works. This is all you have to do. Plant the seed, and you get people like Uncle Joey who don't know anything. But guys, healthcare is a national issue. And like Governor Cuomo says, when I sneeze, you get sick. And this is what it's all about. We all have to take care of each other, make sure we do the best we can. So Judy, let's have clip number two, please.
Not only is it mean, it's not even smart. Because healthcare now is not just about the individual. There's a public health issue. We understand better and better that we are all in one society. And health for one is health for all. If I sneeze, you catch a cold. And germs don't discriminate. Germs don't say, oh, you're Democrat. Oh, you're Republican. Oh, you're a rich person. I won't infect you because you're a rich person. Right? That's public health. You would want to provide health care for everyone to protect everyone.
Guys, see who sent that in? That was sent in by Linda Yana. And it was sent in on Facebook. And guys, I told her I was going to use it on the show. And if you got anything that you'd like to contribute to the show, put it up on Facebook. And if I can use it, I will. And if you have some issues that you want to have addressed, hey, let's talk about it. That's what we have the social media for. And guys, the next clip is going to be about Trump Care 101. So Judy, clip three, please.
Hey, it's Chris Murphy. I wanted to break down for you why the Republican Affordable Care Act repeal bill, otherwise known as Trump Care, is an absolute dumpster fire. It is a disaster for virtually everyone. It solves not a single problem that the Republicans have identified, and we have to use everything we have to defeat it. First problem, number one, it dramatically will cut the number of people who have insurance in this country. First, by ending the expansion of Medicaid, which is covering millions of people all across the country, moms, kids, poor people, middle class folks. Second, it dramatically cuts the amount of money you get to try to help you buy healthcare. And that means that lots of people who bought healthcare on these exchanges won't be able to because they simply don't have the help that they used to from the federal government. It's more cost for everybody. Why? Well, because it ultimately doesn't deliver on the promise that the Affordable Care Act did. The average 60-year-old in Connecticut used to be getting $8,000 in tax credits to help them buy insurance. Under this bill, he'll be getting $4,000 in tax credits. That means that that individual is going to be paying $4,000 more a year for health care. There's nothing in this bill that controls costs, and thus prices will continue to go up and up. Third, there's a specific tax in this bill on older people. Insurance companies are allowed under this bill to dramatically charge more for people that are in their 50s and 60s. An estimate suggests that there will be a $3,000 immediate increase in premiums on the average 50 or 60-year-old in this country because the protections for older consumers, for older patients, are removed in this bill. And finally, the biggest giveaway in this bill, the only people that benefit are millionaires, billionaires. There is a huge tax cut in this bill for people making over $250,000 a year who have unearned income. The average person who gets a tax cut out of this GOP health bill will get $200,000 in taxes back. So everybody loses coverage. Everybody has to deal with higher costs, all in order to finance a giant tax cut for the wealthy. The GOP replacement plan for the Affordable Care Act, Trump Care, is an unmitigated disaster for everybody, written on back of a napkin in the dark so no one could see what they were doing, and we have to organize to make sure that this never, ever becomes law.
So what does it boil down to, guys? It's all about a massive tax cut, a massive tax break for the rich. And how are they able to do this? It's very simple. When you're rich, you can pay to have politicians elected. Hey, you're either going to pay tax or you're going to pay a politician. So rather than pay a tax which benefits everybody, these bozos would rather pay a politician so that they don't have to pay taxes, so that the rich people make off like bandits and the poor people get left holding the bag. And this is what it boils down to. This is the nuts and bolts of it. It's all about the money. Because now the billionaires have to pay their fair share. And they don't want to pay their fair share. They would rather pay lawyers to have laws enacted so that they can skate the tax laws and they don't have to pay. Now, if you're making obscene amounts of money, what could possibly go through your mind that would make you say, I don't want to pay? I'm making a fortune in this country. I'm using this country's roads, bridges, telephone, internet. I'm using everything. And I don't want to pay for it. Joey, does this make sense to you? Is this what you voted for, Joe? Is this what you really want? Is this how you're going to spite yourself? Is this what's going on here, Joe? And in next clip, we're going to show my favorite Bernie. And Bernie puts the cards on the table, and he's a little bit more direct than Chris Murphy was. But I tell you, Bernie crosses the T's and he dots the I. He takes no prisoners. So Judy, let's have clip number four, please.
We're joined now by Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders, who is in Burlington this morning. Senator Sanders, House Speaker Paul Ryan thinks that his legislation can get 51 votes in the Senate. What do you think?
Well, I sure hope not, John. It is an absolute disaster. It is a disgrace. And by the way, this really has nothing to do with health care. What this has everything to do with is a massive shift of wealth from working people and middle-income people to the very richest people in this country. It is a $275 billion tax break for the top 2%. Millionaires will get about $50,000 a year in tax breaks, while at the same time, some 5 to 10 million people are going to lose their health insurance. Premiums are going to soar. The AARP, says that if you are 64 years of age and you're making about $25,000 a year, you're going to pay up to $7,000 more for your health insurance. They're going to defund Planned Parenthood, deny over 2 million women the right to choose the health care that they need. They're going to decimate Medicaid, which is why the American Medical Association, the AMA, and the American Hospital Association oppose it, in addition to the AARP. This is a disgrace. And by the way, they are so cowardly that they want to go forward before the CBO even gives an estimate as to what it will cost and how many people will lose their insurance.
Well, a lot of charges there. The speaker says the CBO will be giving, the accountants in Congress will be giving their score on Monday, so it will be able to be a part of the debate. But let me ask you this question about how many people will lose coverage. What Speaker Ryan says is it's an unfair comparison because the people who have coverage now have coverage in a rickety system that is getting worse. Premiums are going up. Insurance companies are dropping out of the system. So it's unfair to compare the people who have it now because the system's falling apart.
Oh, really? Well, 5 to 10 million people are going to have no health insurance at all. Nobody has ever suggested that the Affordable Care Act, Obamacare, was perfect. But it did put 20 million people into the ranks of the insured. In my view, and what the American people want is an improvement on Obamacare, not the decimation of Obamacare and throwing so many people off of health insurance and raising premiums substantially. It is very hard for Ryan or anybody else not to deny that what they are bringing forth is far, far, far worse than Obamacare, and that its primary purpose is massive tax breaks for the very wealthiest people in this country.
There's been a lot of criticism from some senators about what the House is putting together. I wonder if you see an opportunity to use the opposition against the House bill to do something that's closer to what you want.
Well, John, that is a very fair question. But as I understand it, this bill is so outrageous that not only do the Republicans move forward in the House without the CBO score, they want to move forward in the Senate without any hearings whatsoever. If you realize this bill is going to impact tens and tens of millions of people, and to the best of my knowledge, they want to bring it right to the floor of the Senate. I'm a member of the Health Education Committee. When Obamacare was being debated, we had hearing after hearing, meeting after meeting. It never ended. And these guys want to take a bill so significant to so many people and just shove it through because they don't have the guts to hold hearings. They don't want the American people to know what's going on.
They say that there will be a multi-step process here. This is one step, and then there will be future legislation. So what you might want would be in that future legislation, which would also have a 60-vote threshold. This one has only a 50-vote threshold because of the way it's going through.
Well, they could say what they want, John, but it is impossible for any serious legislator to defend a process by which a bill is coming to the Senate without one hearing before the vote takes place. And I think it's clear to everybody. They want to move as quickly as they can. They are embarrassed about the product. And let's not forget that President Trump, who now, I guess, today at least supports it, we don't know what he will say tomorrow, but Trump was the guy who said to the American people when he ran for president, oh, don't worry, we got a terrific idea. We're going to provide health care to all people. Well, this is far from it. This is throwing 5 to 10 million people off of the health insurance they currently have.
All right, Senator Sanders, we're going to have to leave it there. Thanks so much for being with us.
Thank you.
I was under the impression, I watch a lot of Fox News. I do. I'll be honest, and I tell you, because I love to see how they misconstrue the story, but I watch a lot of Fox News, and I was under the impression that Obamacare was squeezed through. It was jammed down everybody's throats in the dead of night. Guys, I didn't know this, but you're going to know this. They debated Obamacare for over 9 months. Like Bernie said, they had meeting after meeting after meeting. They worked through this. Hey guys, They got a lot accomplished, but you know, it's a mess. It's 1/5 of the economy of the country. It's massive. When you put something that big into effect, there's always, you gotta tweak it. Nothing's perfect. So you look at what's broken and you try to fix it. But the Republicans don't wanna know anything. All they wanna do is repeal it. And they hopefully, the simple folk are gonna say, wait a minute. I voted for Trump, but I ain't voting to pay $4,000 more a year for my health care because of Donald Trump. And guys, this is what it's gonna come, it comes down to nuts and bolts, it comes down to money. And you know, we have to be honest with each other. Nothing's free. Nothing is free. Uncle Joey wants you to think, oh, all the moochers and the takers, they want everything for free. No, we don't want everything for free. But there are better ways to pay for things. And this is what we want to do. But the only thing the Republican Party wants to do is make sure that the people with all the money keep it. I don't want to share it with nobody. And guys, the next clip is going to be the human side of the Affordable Care Act. And this first guy was a conservative, a Republican voter who had to sign up for Obamacare. And he thanks God that he did. Hear that, Uncle Joey? This guy had invisible friends just like you do. And he thanks him for Obamacare and for the Affordable Care Act. So, Judy, let's have clip number 5, please.
They wouldn't sell it to me at any price. It was just not. But that was, I was overweight. So I was a risk.
Back in 2013, Bob Rusko, then 53 years old, was a familiar story in America. Too familiar. He was more than 100 pounds overweight, at risk of heart disease and diabetes. He was also self-employed, and no company wanted to offer him health care insurance. He was considered too big a risk.
Was that tough to go uninsured?
Well, it doesn't make you warm and fuzzy, but I didn't like it, but it was the reality of the situation.
When did you first hear about the Affordable Care Act?
It was all over the news.
What'd you think?
I thought it was a good idea. Even though I'm a conservative.
So when did you first sign up for Obamacare?
When it was first available. It was October, I remember, and I wanted to be covered because it's important.
And as a result, starting in 2014, Bob was able to get insurance after subsidies. It was finally within reach and a big relief.
September was, I can't wait till October. It's the feeling of coming out of the rain, if you will. You know, you're out there to the breezes. You know, you can do all you can, you get healthy, you try to be safe, but there's a certain amount of fate that's just out there. So to have coverage, it was, whew.
Which makes what happened next all the more surprising.
Repeal and replace.
Look, okay, you voted for Donald Trump, who promised to repeal something that you're very much benefiting from. Again, just how do you explain that to people?
I did what I thought was correct for the overall good of the country. I think economic strength cures a lot of things. People working, making decent money, that certainly helps out. I'd rather not need the subsidies. I'd rather be working.
We are repealing and replacing Obama. We can reverse the stagnation and usher in a period of true opportunity and growth.
That repealing Obamacare would be good for the economy. It's a common refrain. But the Committee for a Responsible Federal Budget suggests the opposite. They say fully repealing Obamacare would cost roughly $350 billion over 10 years and would also increase the number of uninsured by 23 million.
If he does repeal Obamacare, as he's promised to do, what is that going to mean for you?
No insurance.
No insurance.
No insurance.
That was a big problem for you before.
I wasn't happy about it.
Truth is, some of the states that most benefited from Obamacare had a majority who voted for Trump, like Rusko's home state of Florida. In fact, Florida has the highest percentage of enrollees in the nation. 1 in 10 Floridians under 65 signed on for health insurance through the Affordable Care Act.
One in 10, 10% of the Floridians.
Rusko credits Obamacare with profoundly changing his health. And because of that, this lifelong conservative wrestled for the first time with the idea of voting Democrat.
If I'd have voted for what I thought was strictly best for me, I would have voted for her. Because the health care plan gives us peace of mind, medical screening to stop something before it gets worse. And look at how many things have gotten better.
Rusko says he has no regrets about voting for President-elect Trump, but he would tell him this.
Each day we face the possibility of losing our home, going into bankruptcy. One thing could come in. The Health Care Act has taken that worry away.
Dr. Sanjay Gupta, CNN, West Palm Beach, Florida.
Guys, did you see that? He voted for Trump because he voted for what he thought was best for the country. So by voting for what he thought was best for the country, he ended up screwing himself. Sounds counterintuitive, doesn't it? But this is the dilemma you're faced with. And, you know, hopefully, you know, we'll be able to change things. All right, now, we're going to come up with a still now, and this is a still that shows us... Oh, okay. Oh, hello?
Yes, hello?
Hello, can you... All right, you're on.
Oh, good. I have a question for you regarding health care.
Sure.
Something that I've been thinking about. It's... you know, whether you're for or against the various health care bills, but what kind of bothers me is the amount of sickness that is in our country. And I just kind of wonder if I think the Food and Drug Administration has done a horrible job that we have to go out of our way to buy organic, that if you go to Stop and Shop, they miraculously have a pharmacy there. They figure, you know, you go get the food in aisle 5, and then you can go get your diabetes medicine when you have to. At one point, do we really start taking some of these agencies to task?
You know, that's a good question because, you know, supposedly, and I'm going to be honest with you because I don't know that much about it, but the way that the drug pricing is set up, I mean, you've got these lobbyists who are able to get these, you know what? I tell you what, on the next show, I'm going to address this question and we'll take a good, serious look at it and we'll see exactly why the drug companies are able to get away with the nonsense that they're able to get away with. And I think what we're going to find once again is it all comes down to money. You know, how these drug companies can make billions of dollars in profit, obscene amounts of money in profit. And that's one of the reasons why I'm sick and tired. I want to thank you for the call. We're going to move forward now, and we're going to show you one last still on exactly, I love showing charts. Thanks for the call. And Judy, can we have the next still? I want to show the caller exactly how Obama, there we go. Now guys, take a look at this. These are the tax credits for lower income people under the House Republican Affordable Care Act replacement. Guys, if you look on the left-hand side where there's a $20,000 income for somebody age 27, under the Affordable Care Act, the average credit that a 27-year-old would get would be $3,225. Under the American Health Care Act, which is Trump Care, that same individual will only get $2,000. Guys, that's a big difference, isn't it? And then if you look at the $40,000, you know, just look at the difference in the prices, guys. And if you want to take a snippet of this so that you can refer to it, But if you make over $100,000 with the American health care, you're going to get money back. Like a guy making $100,000 a year needs to have a tax incentive. All right. And Judy, let's go to the next still. And guys, the next still is going to start the second half of the show. And this is what got Donald Trump into so much trouble. Tweeting on a Saturday morning. And look at this. This is March 4th. This is the day our friends up in Southbury had their march. And Trump tweeted, how low has President Obama gone to tap my phones during the very sacred election process? This is Nixon Watergate bad or sick guy. Donald Trump, I bet a good lawyer could make a great case out of the fact that President Obama was tapping my phones in October just prior to the election. Donald Trump, is it legal for a sitting president to be wiretapping a race for president prior to the election? Turned down by court earlier, a new low. Judy, come back to me. So guys, nobody was watching the president at 6:30 in the morning on Saturday, and he must have picked up an article from Breitbart. And because nobody was holding on to the Trump leash, he tweeted this out and he opened up a whole can of worms. And the first clip we're going to show you is, why is Trump so terrified of the free press? Guys, why do you think he would be terrified of the free press? Is it because the free press will tell the truth and correct Trump when he says something that misleads the simple folk? When he tries to mislead Uncle Joey and tell him that he's going to get cheaper and better health care? Doesn't the press have the right to say, Uncle Joey, he's not telling you the truth? And I tell you, guys, sometimes the way Uncle Joey thinks, I think you have to talk to him very slowly. Right, Joey? I love Uncle Joey, but let's be honest, the elevator don't go to the top floor. So anyway, let's see why Trump is so terrified of the free press. Clip 8, Judy.
That has had some difficulty telling the truth and that has seemed to have trouble getting up to speed on the basic competent functioning of government, and a president who seems particularly averse to any criticism and has called the press the enemies of the American people, they are taking the next step in attempting to avoid checks and balances and accountability. It's not acceptable. In fact, it's petulant and indicative of a lack of basic understanding of how an adult White House functions. In fact, Sean Spicer in December seemed to completely understand this. He said the White House would not ban any media organization as the Trump campaign had. He said, quote, we have a respect for the press when it comes to the government. That is something you can't ban an entity from, conservative, liberal, or otherwise. I think that's what makes a democracy versus a dictatorship. The Trump White House now, led by Sean Spicer's White House operation in the communication division, is now targeting multiple media organizations, and it seems to think it can punish reporters for sharing with you facts that they don't like. They offer rhetoric designed to mislead and confuse you about this issue, such as this from the president today.
We are fighting the fake news. It's fake, phony, fake. A few days ago, I called the fake news the enemy of the people, and they are. They are the enemy of the people.
The enemy of the people.
Because they have no sources. They just make them up when there are none.
It's just simply not true. So don't misunderstand what's going on with that rhetoric and with today's action banning various media outlets, including CNN and the New York Times. This White House does not seem to respect the idea of accountability. This White House does not seem to value an independent press. There is a word for that line of thinking. The word is un-American.
Un-American, it's worse than that. Guys, Fake news. And we did show 158 on fake news. So if you want to watch that, but guys, I tell you, if if Trump wasn't terrified by the free press, he's going to go berserk when he finds out his phones were tapped. And speaking of phones, what a beautiful segue, huh? You're on Who's Telling the Truth?
Yeah, exactly. When they're talking about fake news, they're really talking about themselves.
Yeah.
And so far as the FDA goes, and Drug Association, they're associated. There you go.
Okay.
Later.
All right. Don't forget to keep watching and call back. Thank you.
Don't forget to watch Bernie tonight.
Oh, yeah. Oh, thanks for reminding me right after the show's over. Thank you. Hey, guys, tonight at 8 o'clock, right after the show ends, Bernie's going to be on, he's doing a town hall from, I think it's West Virginia. He's going to go right into the belt of coal country and say, listen, here's another thing Trump lied to you about. Coal ain't coming back. It's a clean coal is an oxymoron. Get it out of your mind. Just get it out of your mind. But the next clip we're going to do, like we said, if Trump is terrified over the free press, he's going to be shitting bricks when he thinks his phones are tapped. So, Judy, clip number 9, please.
Coming to that point, I want to touch again back on this claim about the wiretap. The President of the United States is the ultimate authority. He is Commander in Chief. But if he was the target, they do have the right to withhold information from him. He does not have a need to know on a counterintelligence investigation if he is actually suspected of doing activities. And the people who would be doing this, it would be a very close hold thing, maybe 1, 2, 3 people in the United States government. But, you know, he is acting this morning like that information is real, which means he's confirming everything that we suspect. And by running around and tweeting about it, that he's afraid of it, he knows something's going on and he's trying to project a frame of reference around information that he suspects is coming out. If he thinks his phones were tapped, then he believes we know everything. And this is a dance that is very dangerous. I think this is a historic moment by learning this information this morning.
Something's wrong here, guys, when the President of the United States can pick up the phone and call his Attorney General and say to his Attorney General, I want the Pfizer court reports on my desk in 5 minutes. Do you know what? Trump should be able to do it, but why hasn't he called for the Pfizer reports? Because it's gonna prove that he's a liar. He's a lying sack of crap. But you know what? People like Joey, they're good, loyal soldiers. They'll stand behind and they'll defend Trump regardless of what he does. Doesn't matter how delusional he is. And people that defend Trump are sick. And this next clip, we're going to show you just how sick Kellyanne is. So, Judy, let's have clip number 12, please. Kellyanne,
do you know whether Trump Tower was wiretapped?
What I can say is there are many ways to surveil each other now, unfortunately.
Do you believe
there was an article this week that talked about how you can surveil someone through their phones, certainly through their television sets, any number of different ways, and microwaves that turn into cameras, etc. So we know that that is just a fact of modern life.
Yeah.
Wait a minute, where'd Judy go? Wait. Guys, after I saw this clip, I went upstairs and I was making my coffee and I was talking to my microwave. And if Kellyanne Conway thinks that your microwave is listening to you, and if your TV is watching you, guys, we got a lot of trouble. But I asked Uncle Joey. I said, Joey, is your TV watching you? And of course, Rich, you don't know. You really don't. Okay. And I tell Joey this simple thing. Joey, have you checked under your bed recently? There's a rat under your bed, baby. Guys, I'm telling you, they're going to kill Uncle Rich with the stuff there. I can't take it anymore. I mean, when you hear somebody tell you that your TV's watching you and you could talk to your microwave, something's wrong. So guys, now we're going to play the full clip, and you can see just how delusional Kellyanne is. So Judy, clip 13.
Do you know whether Trump Tower was wiretapped?
What I can say is there are many ways to surveil each other now, unfortunately.
Do you believe
there was an article this week that talked about how you can surveil someone through their phones, through their, certainly through their television sets, any number of different ways, and microwaves that turn into cameras, etc. So we know that that is just a fact of modern
sure.
life.
Yeah.
I wasn't making a suggestion about the Trump Tower. These are two separate
things.
That's
what you were asked about.
And I answered him about surveilling generally.
But you have no evidence that that kind of surveillance was used against Trump Tower.
I have no evidence, but that's why there's an investigation
no
in Congress.
Evidence.
Are we going to have real facts on this afternoon?
The president called for the House and Senate Intelligence Committees to add this piece of the investigation to an existing investigation, and he's pleased that that is happening. We won't really comment further until those findings are complete. I'm not in the job of having evidence. That's what investigations are for. I'm not Inspector Gadget.
Guys, I mean, what do you say? I have no evidence. Why did you say it then? Well, why not? I could say anything I want. It's a free speech. This is America, isn't it? Yeah, this is America. But that's why we always say, be specific and cite your sources. It's really simple. It's really simple. And why these guys, you know, why Matt Lauer and the other guys, wait, Kellyanne, look at me. Look me in the eye. Now tell me, are you lying to me or not? Just be honest. Are you lying or not? That's all. What is she gonna do? They gotta get rid of her. They gotta get rid of all these clowns. And guys, we're gonna have more fun because she was on further on Good Morning America, and Stephanopoulos, he just had a lot of fun with her. And you'll see how the deception just spins around. So Judy, clip 14, please.
Comment about the articles from this past week where it is revealed that one can be surveilled in any number of techniques, through microwaves, through cameras, through televisions. I wasn't talking about anything
specifically. Do you know whether the Trump Tower was wiretapped? And you answered by citing this report about the CIA techniques revealed by WikiLeaks. Why would you make a suggestion like that without any evidence?
I wasn't making a suggestion about Trump Tower. These are two separate things.
That's what you were asked about.
And I answered him about surveilling generally.
But you have no evidence that that kind of surveillance was used against Trump Tower.
I have no evidence, but that's why there's an investigation in Congress. That's particularly what investigations are for.
That's why my mom always told me to stay away from microwaves when they were on, right?
That I think that is true. That was awful. She's really...
It's pretty inexplicable.
It speaks for itself, America.
Yeah.
Come on now.
And by the way, even if it were true, they'd still need a FISA warrant, right, if they were...
It's really awful. It's so, it's very, very, very sad what's happening. And everybody has to sort of let the story speak for itself and understand the story as time goes by. I just hope not too much time goes by.
But traditionally, when someone so close to the president is held accountable for everything.
Well, the president must like this. He must think she's doing a good job.
On inauguration day, you had a story for me of something you saw. I'm just letting it hang out there, just like I'll let that hang. Because there's nothing I want to attach to it. I just want to stay as far away as possible from trying to engage with someone who seems to have an audience of one who may not have the country's best interest in mind. We'll put it that way. Okay. Inauguration Day.
It was the first inauguration I covered, and of course I wanted to see every single aspect of it, what you see on television and what you don't. And we had a very great great positioning as far as where the Yahoo camera was, and we could see everything 200 feet away. And so we saw the president, saw the speech, and I thought, could wave at President Trump at the time. And when it was a rainy day, as you recall, and when everyone was going in, I told you this, the last two people, because again, I was taking all of this in, the last two people remaining who went up to the stand together in the podium to sort of take it all in were Kellyanne Conway and Steve Bannon, together side by side. And it was just such a visual to see, because everyone was rushing inside to escape the rain, and yet these two were taking in the moment. And it was the fact that it was these two people together. Yep. And they were enjoying it, and it was her birthday, and there was nothing wrong with them being there per se. It was just these two figures
taking it all
taking
in.
It all in.
You know, these guys sat around the table almost in stunned silence. You know, what do you say when you hear somebody speak of nonsense like this? I mean, they're like saying, wait a minute, did she really just say that? She's the chief advisor to the president, and she's coming up with this nonsense? But wait, it gets worse, because the next clip we're gonna play here is Stephanopoulos this morning delving into it even further. Is that another call we got? Holy mackerel, this is a record. Thanks for calling. Who's telling the truth?
Calling back again. What does she have on Trump to keep that job or to get that job later?
I hear you. Very good. You know what I want to know? I want to know what the Russians have on Trump. I mean, they got something on him where, hey, they're making him toe the line. He's their puppet. And Trump went berserk when he was called Putin's puppet. But hey, you know, the facts are facts. All right, so the next clip we're gonna show you is George Stephanopoulos having even more fun. So Judy, clip 15, please.
Thanks, Robin. We are now joined from the White House by Sarah Huckabee Sanders, spokesperson for the president. Sarah, thank you for joining us this morning. So we now know that the FBI director has told the Justice Department that President Trump's explosive claims are inaccurate. Does President Trump accept the FBI director's denial?
You know, I don't think he does, George. I think he firmly believes that this is a storyline that has been reported pretty widely by quite a few outlets. The wiretapping has been discussed in the New York Times, BBC, Fox News, and we believe that
Sarah,
it should be
I have to stop you right there. Every single article you just mentioned does not back up the president's claim that President Obama had him wiretapped. Not a single one of them set up. So what is the president's evidence?
It does back up the fact that the administration was wiretapping American citizens. There was a wide reporting suggesting that his administration, whether it was directly ordered by this president specifically, his administration could have done
Sarah,
this.
Sarah, I have got
and
to
look,
stop you
George,
again. No, Sarah, I've got to stop you again because that is simply not true. All the articles you just mentioned, not one of them says that President Trump ordered a wiretap. One of them based on one of them based on anonymous sources says there might have been a court-ordered FISA wiretap. That has been denied by the former director of National Intelligence, James Clapper.
Look, I love how now anonymous sources don't matter anymore. We've been dealing with anonymous sources and having to fight back against that for the last 6 months. It's funny how the media
but Sarah,
now
hold
starts
on a
to,
second. Sarah, even to, if that one is true, even if that one is true, that is saying it was a court-ordered wiretap, not an illegal wiretap ordered by President Obama.
Look, it would have been under this administration, George. You don't get to just wash your hands of something, whether it's the Justice Department under which you control, which would have fallen under this administration and under this past president. I think the bigger question here is, let's let the House Intelligence
Sarah,
Committee do
that
its
is,
job,
that is simply,
George.
That
they
is
committed
not true.
Over the weekend.
Sarah,
they
hold on a second. Hold on a second. That is not true. There is a world of difference between an illegal wiretap ordered by a president and a court-ordered wiretap approved by a federal judge. That there's a world of difference between those two things.
The fact that it was being done is a story that we should be talking about, George, and all we're asking is that we let Congress do its job. Let's let the House Intelligence Committee review this, investigate it, as they committed to do over the weekend. Look, there have been a constant allegations. The hypocrisy on this story is absolutely outrageous. We have dealt with this for the last 6 months, where calls this story false. The FBI comes out and says it's BS. The House Intelligence Committee says there's no evidence. Yet you, the people in the media continue to report a false narrative that there are connections between the Trump campaign and the Russians when there simply aren't. All we're asking is the same fair deal here, that the House Intelligence Committee is given the opportunity to investigate, review this, and see if there's anything there,
Sarah,
which we believe there is.
It is not a fact that this has been done. You do not know that it is a fact that this has been done, and that has been denied by President Obama, by the former director of national intelligence, and now we know it as well by the FBI director. They are all saying it did not happen. So is the president calling all three of those individuals liars?
Not at all. He's asking that we allow the House Intelligence Committee to do its job the same way we have done on our situation. It's very interesting, George, how when this past president says it's false, everybody's like, oh, well, obviously it is. But when we've been saying it for the last 6 months, nobody believes it. Frankly, George, I think if the president walked across the Potomac, the media would report that he can't swim. This is a constant battle that we're having to fight. All we're asking is that this double standard be washed
Sarah,
away, and that we allow the congressional committee to do their job.
Sarah, the president made these allegations 48 hours ago. Has he called the FBI director since he made those allegations and asked if they were true?
I don't know that he has talked directly with the FBI director, but I do believe that, again, we go back to, we've put out a statement asking that we allow Congress to do its job and investigate and do a full review of this
but
process.
The president administers the Justice Department. The president administers the intelligence agencies. He can find out for himself. He can ask his FBI director if this is true. He can ask his Justice Department if this is true. He can ask the director of national intelligence if this is true. Has he done that?
Look, I don't know that actually that is the case, George. From my understanding is that this has to follow, and in order to go.
Guys, they could find out what they, if they wanted to find out, they could find out what the FISA court ordered. It's that simple. Guys, we'll see you next week. We're going to talk about drugs. Toodles.
Thanks, Robin. We are now joined from.